I just got home and freshened up my makeup a little bit and changed into my concert outfit. It's actually really nice and warm out now. On my lips, I'm wearing Rouge Volupt number 1 by YSL. And I have a little bit of gloss on top. The Maybelline contour palette, the lightest one on the cheeks. I still love that palette so much. I only ever use the contour and the blush shade though. I don't use the highlight, but that's what I have on my cheeks. And then on my eyes, I went all Burberry today. I'm wearing Burberry Pale Barley, Midnight Brown, and Burberry Almond in the crease. I'm running late. I was supposed to leave the house. It's 6:06. I was supposed to leave the house 6 minutes ago. I'm only human, can't you see? I made a mistake. Please just look me in my face. Tell me everything's okay. 'Cause I got it. Ooh, I'll never be like you.
Turned out great, didn't it?
You got your door knocker polished, yeah.
Is there any nail salon?
Oh yeah, that's way better than the other one. Looks good.
I should grab a shot of espresso.
Oh, yeah.
Saturday.
You want a shot of espresso before?
I'm gonna get a double spot shot. My back hurts.
I take him to a concert and you can't hear the next day.
We had to stand for 2 hours.
And then we were complaining that our backs were hurting. So yeah, I think we've officially crossed the line.
Should have taken my little rascal.
You think they're having a meeting? Maybe it's a marketing meeting, like in Silicon Valley.
Oh god, the marketing team is having another bike meeting.
We're scouting locations for my fashion video. And we are, what is this?
Angel Hall.
Our friend Fred, you might remember Fred from my LA vlog last year, but he opened his own little restaurant, and it's on South U in Ann Arbor. It's called Fred's, and it's lovely. They do avocado toast, really, really good acai bowls, a lot of healthy food options. It's a great place to check out if you are in Ann Arbor. Our first outdoor meal of 2016. Yummy. Potatoes, beans, rice, avocado, and pico de gallo. Yummy.
Look at the beer garden.
I know, there's a huge line to get in. We're on our way to get ice cream. The line to the ice cream shop is even longer than it was this morning.
Oh gosh. Why is it so long?
It better be worth it if we're gonna wait in line. What's the verdict? Is it worth it?
Well, they don't have sorbet, but they have fresh basil, lavender, lemon, honey, and salted caramel.
Last time I saw you, I was eating ice cream on the weekend. Fast forward to Wednesday. It's now Wednesday morning. I am at the airport and I'm heading to New York and I'm really excited. I am going to be there just for a couple of days for an event with L'Oreal and I'm super, super excited. On my way to the airport, I was trying to pay the fee to cross the border and my credit card got declined and I was like, that's weird, that's not normal. I found out that there's been fraudulent activity on my credit card and so they had to shut it down. There's all these anonymous weird transactions that I did make. So that's just a bit of an inconvenience for it to happen right before a trip. But thankfully, I have my debit cards. So yeah, let's get the show on the road. Finally made it. I think I should probably give you a room tour before I unleash my belongings all over the place. But this room is huge, especially for New York City standards. There's a lot of light. You walk in and you have a little vanity area. Toilet and shower are over there. And I'm assuming this is the closet. Yes. Whoa. Funky robes. There's a giant bathtub, beautiful bed, high ceilings. This is so, so nice. And then the most amazing urban view. I now have to quickly degrease my face, change, and go grab some lunch with the L'Oreal ladies. I can't wait. I'm so excited to be here. Ugh, I can't believe I have all this room to myself. To the Museum of Modern Art, which is awesome. I've always wanted to go there. So that was really fun. I'm just gonna change, freshen up really quick, and get ready for dinner. I will see you later, and hopefully this will look a little bit nicer next time I see you. All right, so here is my outfit. I have my trench coat. This is from Armani Exchange. High-waisted pants. The pants are from Zara. This is from Aritzia. And then nude heels from Nine West. So it's kind of Inspector Gadget meets the genie. And for makeup, wearing Tom Ford Coco Mirage eyeshadow palette, the Maybelline contour kit on the cheeks, and then on my lips, I'm wearing Nude Sticks Belle. And the foundation is by Terry Cover Expert. This is just, when in doubt, this is the foundation that I pack. Look inside and out, there's an attraction. Keeping all the secrets, then I swear. I've been up since 6, I think, 6:30. I do have about 2.5 hours of free time before the L'Oreal event today. I want to say that I'm very disappointed by this thing. I got a couple of samples of the Omorovica Thermal Cleansing Balm, and I used one of them last night, and then I brought an extra to maybe use this morning. There's such a greasy residue, and I washed it off with a washcloth, and then even on the sink, it left like this thick, oily residue, so yeah. I don't know if I just got a busted sample. That's why I'm gonna use it again this morning and see if it does the same thing. So this is what it looks like when it comes out. I was expecting more of like a clay texture, but it's not. It's very oily, which is nice. It feels amazing when you put it on. So you emulsify it and it's oily. Yeah, it still didn't rinse clean. Maybe it's supposed to do that. Maybe it's supposed to leave an oily residue to nourish the skin or something like that. But yeah, I'm not a fan of the way my skin feels after washing it off, which is a bummer because I really like putting it on. It's a nice experience, but I think this might be too heavy for me. And now, because I want to get really wild, I'm going to hit the mini bar. I put a sheet mask in there, so. Always end up getting stuck in the stinky elevator. There's like carpet on the walls and on the ground. It's very intense. I'm definitely more of a stealth vlogger. I try to do it when no one's watching, but it's pretty much impossible here. So I'm just gonna let my freak flag fly. These little snacks are the best. So I was dreaming deep, but now I'm shallow. Pulling at the string until it tears. I'll always be there for you. I'll always be there for you. Try to let you go, but still I suffer. It's a danger I could never dare. So I'll always be there for you. Instagram genius. Yeah. And I'm already in my robe. I'm getting ready to shower and get ready for bed. Tomorrow's Friday. I actually have to go to work tomorrow. Back to reality, but it's been such a fun couple of days with L'Oreal in New York City. It was awesome. I'm actually really excited to use some of the products, the new skincare products that they're launching. I'm actually really sad because I couldn't take everything back with me because it wouldn't fit in my, it would go past like the liquid restriction. So I actually was not able to bring the face masks with me, which I'm sad because I really wanted to do like a nice, one of the nice new L'Oreal face masks tonight, but they're gonna have to send them to me in the mail. But I'm actually really excited about these new products. I'm gonna show you two things. First thing is glycolic peel pads. This is the new L'Oreal Vitalift Bright Reveal Brightening Peel Pads. These have 10% glycolic acid in them, and I believe they launch in the United States July 1st. They launch in Canada a little bit later, maybe July 15th, something like that. But it's going to be nice to try out some glycolic pads that are very potent at a lower price point. So I'm going to give these a try. And the other thing I really liked, I loved the texture of this. Revitalift Bright Reveal Brightening Dual Overnight Moisturizer. This has vitamin C in it. It also has glycolic and retinol in it. So it's got all the good things. I like the packaging too. It's really funky. They have separated the formulas in two different tubes in order to prevent things from reacting with each other. I think Clarins has a serum that has a similar concept. I think I had maybe 15 minutes in total of time to shop. I got a shirt. It's actually really wrinkly right now because it was in my luggage, but I got this cute, whoa, this looks so bad in the viewfinder, but I promise you it's cute. I'm gonna iron it and show it to you. I'm gonna wear it in one of my future videos or something. It's one of those cold shoulder tops. It's from H&M, and I loved the color. It's a beautiful neutral shade, and the fabric is super, super nice. It's very soft. And then the other thing I got is this like bolero style necklace, choker type of thing. These things are hot at the moment, and I just got this from Forever 21. I didn't want to spend a lot of money on something so trendy. This nice metallic part that you can actually move, so if you want it, you know, if you want like a metallic choker look, you can wear it this way. If you want it, you know, just to show the black, you can twist it so like the metal part will be behind you and you can't really see it, and then just tie it in a nice little bow at the front. And it also has these cute little tassels at the end. So it's a very trendy necklace. It's about $6 from Forever 21, and they do have it online as well. So I'm gonna link to it in the description box if you're interested. Anyway, I'm going to shut up now. I hope you have had a fantastic week, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye. You caught me in your snare. A good gift.